Hi, this is my fourth lecture. In this lecture, we'll be seeing the database users. In previous lecture, we have seen the advantages of database management system. So, in today's lecture, we'll be seeing the users of database. Basically, we have two types of users we have. One is actors on the scene, and the next one is workers behind the scenes. Means the workers, the one who work on the database, are actors on the scene. Workers behind the scene is they are working for the database, like defining the database, like adding tools, adding packages in the database software. Those all comes under the workers behind the scene. So the first one is actors on the scene. In this we have three categories we have in actors on scene. The first one is database administrator, DBAs, database designers and end users. So who are database administrators? We call them as DBAs. These are responsible for managing the database system, authorizing the access, coordinating and monitoring users, and acquiring the resources. DBAs are the main people who will have the authority to give the accessibility. Like, for example, we have A, B, C user we have. All these three are want to access the database. But DBAs are responsible for giving the authority accessibility to all these people. And they will coordinate to coordinating the people and monitor the users. Whoever is using the database, they will monitor it. So these are DBAs. Next comes database designers. As the name suggests, these are the one who will design the structure of your database. For example, you want to store movies database. You want to create a database for a movies. For movies, you will be having movie ID and movie name. And next, if you want to store the actor and actress names, all these kind of details you want to store. So database designers are the one who will design your database. Means they will define the structure for your database. See here, the database designers are responsible for identifying the data to be stored, choosing the structure to be represent and store this data. Means they are the one who will design this structure. In this structure, the users will store their data. They communicate with the prospective database user in order to understand the requirements and to come up with the design. So these are mainly responsible for designing the structure of your database. Means how you want to store the data is depends on the database designer. The customer will tell the designers, like, this kind of data I want to store, and in this manner I want to store the data. So database designer will define or create the structure according to their requirements. So these are database designers. Next comes end users. End users also comes under actors on the scene. Means these are the one, the end users are like we. What we do, we just use that software and we create a database and we use it, right? So end users are the one who use the system at the end. So under end user, we have another three categories. One is casual end user, पैरामेट्रिक और नेम एंड यूजर, सोफिस्टिकेटेड एंड यूजर. दिस इज इम्पोर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट. Like for 2 months and all, you will get this question: who are parametric user, who are name users? Like this kind of question they'll ask. So what? Who are the end users? As I have told you, the users who are going to use the system at the end. The person that use the database for querying, updating, and generating the reports. These are the users who will generate the reports, or if they want to access the data from the database, they can do all these tasks. Next, under end users, we have three categories: casual end user, parametric or name end user, sophisticated end user. So who are the casual end users? These casual end users are called, also called as occasional users. Means the one who occasionally use the software. For example, in previous lecture I have taken one student database. Who all use this student database? Mainly I have created three users in this. Three users. Who are those? One is office people, one is lecturers, and management people. All these three end users are going to use this student database. Who will use the student database occasionally? Obviously, the management team. They will use occasionally. They don't use every day. For example, office people and lecturers will use on daily basis. So casual end users are the one who use the system or you use the database occasionally. Means they just want to access the data. They don't want to manipulate the data. For example, how many students are there in our college? They want to check. So they will just check the database occasionally, and they just want to generate the reports. So those are casual end users. Next comes parametric or naive end users. They use the pre-programmed or canned transaction to interact continuously with the database. See, here this office people and lecturers, they use every day. This student database, they use it every day, and those are comes under parametric or naive end user. For example, I have a student database. What office people wants to do is, today one new admission has taken, so they want to update the student database. We have 101 roll number or serial number, student name you will write, and then you will write phone number, then you write his address and all. So these parametric or naive end users are the one who use it on daily basis. Next comes sophisticated end users. These are the end users who, like, it includes engineers, scientists, business analysts and others who use the full DBMS capabilities for implementing the complex application. So sophisticated end users are the end users, like, for example, I am a programmer. I want to create one database. For example, I want to create hospital database. So I will use this software, DBMS software, to create my hospital database. So sophisticated end users are the one who use the software to build their own databases. Those are sophisticated end users. Next comes standalone users. The one who wants to create the personal databases. For example, can have your own database to store your own data. Those are standalone users. And two more actors on scene we have. One is system analyst and application programmers. And application programmers. See here. System analyst and application programmers are the actors on scene. These comes under actors on scene. These develop the specification for candy transaction that meet the requirements of name or parametric end users. See, system analyst or the application programmers are the ones who will write the database, means they will write the query to create their own database. These are like software engineers. They can develop their own software to help others. For example, we have MS Office, right? Who will use this MS Office? Everybody uses this MS Office software. So system analyst and application programmers are the one who will create a database, and that database can be used by anybody. So all these comes under actors on scene: database administrator, database designer, end users, and system analyst and application programmers. Next category we have is workers behind the scene. Means these people doesn't come on the scene. They will work behind the scene. DBMS system designers and implementers are the person who design and implement the DBMS modules and interfaces as software packages. In previous lecture, we have seen the advantages, right? One of the advantage what we have is it support multiple user interface. So who will create the interfaces? I have discussed already, we have different interfaces, GUI, form based interface we have, menu based interface we have, natural language interface we have. So we have different interfaces. So DBMS system designers are the one who will design the interfaces and modules. Next we have tool developers. We have a DBMS software. Under a particular software, we have different tools or packages. So these tool developers are the one who will develop the packages for better performance. For every, as we all know, we all use the Android version, right? Android. What is Android? It is an operating system. We have seen many versions. Android version 1, 2, 3, like this. Whenever they release the new version, they will add some extra features to it, right? So for why they are adding the extra features? For better performance. So what tool developers does is, tool developers are the one who will add extra features to your software. They will add extra tools or extra packages to the existing software for a better performance. Then we have last operators and maintenance. These are the people who will maintain the software. Whatever DBMS software we have, these operators and the maintenance will be done by these people. So these comes under workers behind the scene. So there are DBMS system engineers, tool developers, operators, and maintenance personnel. These three comes under workers behind the scene. I hope you all understood today's lecture. We have seen database user, actors on the scene, workers behind the scene. See you all in next lecture.